What started with a whistleblower in Phoenix has now grown into a nationwide investigation into how the government cares for our veterans. Today, the president spoke out on the issue and lawmakers passed a bill hoping to make change. The 10 News military reporter Bob Lawrence is here with what veterans are saying about the system here in San Diego. Bob.
Well, Steve, while not perfect, the San Diego does get high marks, at least from the veterans that we spoke with. Now, the president weighed in on those allegations at 26 other facilities that are now under investigation for patients that not only died waiting for care, but that the VA covered it up. The scandal started here at the VA facility in Phoenix. 71-year-old Thomas Breen went to the emergency room last September and was told to see a doctor within a week. His appointment came months later.
He called me December 6th. He's dead already.
Breen had stage 4 bladder cancer. The VA in Phoenix and 25 others allegedly doctored appointment schedules to hide wait times.
These allegations prove to be true. It is dishonorable. It is disgraceful. And I will not tolerate it, period.
San Diego's not one of those 26 facilities.
Jeff Gehring is the director of VA healthcare in San Diego. While not part of the inspector general's investigation, on Monday and Tuesday, there was an independent audit.
They looked at how things again were done here at La Jolla, Oceanside, and Mission Valley, and they did not find any gaming in the system.
San Diego is home to the largest number of Iraq and Afghanistan veterans in the nation, a system that overall sees upwards of 75,000 patients a year, more than any other. Vietnam veteran Dempster Cherry said he'd rather drive from his home in Riverside County than to a closer facility.
Sometimes it's a little difficult to get an appointment, but when I do get the appointment, it's excellent service here.
Richard Gilbert, who served in Iraq with a mortar team and who helped open the Veterans Center at UCSD, said on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the highest.
I would say, as far as the medical treatment, I'd get it a solid 8.
Despite calls for the head of the VA, Eric Shinseki, to resign, the president wanted the investigation to run its course. He expects preliminary findings by next month. Bob Lawrence, 10 News.
And today, legislators passed a bill that would give the Secretary of Veteran Affairs greater authority to remove or demote hospital directors.